Why was it important to open up relations between the U.S. and Libya?
You can't have development, growth, tourism, foreign investment, peace here, like stability, and you are at war with the superpower. And now instead of sending bombs to each other, we are sending money and companies and know-how and anything is useful now for both sides, and it's a win-win situation.
How do you see Libya's place in the world economy?
Now we are attracting a lot of investment from all over the world, especially in the oil and gas sector. Now a lot of money coming from the Gulf region to Libya and the real estate. Now Europeans are coming and investing, and the Americans, in tourism, in the hotels, and we are privatizing our public sector slowly, opening up the economy, but still there are a lot of things to be done.
With a vibrant economy, do you hope that economic change and development will lead to political change in this country?
I talked about the constitution, civil rights, about civil society, efficient government, and at the same time, I talked about tourism, opening up the country, no visa, no restrictions. And my idea is not that the economic reforms will, you know, will pull the political one, but we should push both of them at the same time.
You've said in the past that Libya's got to get out of the forest of dictatorship of Africa. Is Libya a dictatorship?
I haven't said that a dictatorship, but we are not a real democracy yet.
One man calls the shots in this country, though. That's your father.
Yes. He's the leader. He's the most important man.
And the democracy that you want to see in this country is going to take time because you have all these obstacles that you're confronting.
I mean, the issue is we have to start now. We have to start now, but how long time it will take is a different question. And Libya now in the 2008 is not Libya 10 years ago. It's a different state, and we need our friends, like the Americans, to help us to rebuild our country, to have democracy, to help us to have a constitution, to have good infrastructure, to have the right investment here in Libya, to help us to increase our oil production, and now we are doing business. And I think doing business is better than fighting.
Your decision to declare and then to begin to dismantle the nuclear program and the chemical weapons program, you said at the time that Libya expected some enormous benefit, a very real benefit. And many people in Libya say they're still waiting for that benefit. What is Libya waiting for? What do you expect from the West?
I don't believe America fulfilled its commitments and pledges vis-à-vis Libya regarding this point. We have been told that President Bush is a man that honors his own word, and so far we are not so sure of that.
What specifically are you waiting for the U.S. to do? What complaint do you have with President Bush?
Libya has not been rewarded for the good service that it did to world peace. Plus, America has not done so far any action to make a country like Libya, between two brackets, has been able to transform the use of nuclear weapons from military use to peaceful use. Libya has not benefited from that, and Libya has not been made an example to other countries to follow suit. So other countries say, what is the benefit? Libya has not been made an example, has not been helped, has not been assisted in this use. So what's the point of scrapping the nuclear program?
Do you regret having made the decision now? Are you sorry that you gave up the nuclear program?
No, we did not regret that because this is a decision of our own volition, of our conviction.
The International Atomic Energy Agency won the Nobel Peace Prize this year for its work in trying to police nuclear programs around the world. They didn't seem to suspect what Libya was up to. What did you think of it, the award? that was handed out to them?
If there is a peace prize, it would be given to Libya.
Mostly IAEA.
Not the IAEA. The International Atomic Energy, the IAEA, would be given such a prize if it has been successful in disarming the nuclear weapons all over the world. Has it been successful in disarming nuclear weapons from any country that has such a weapon? It did not happen. So it was given a prize or award for what? At the expense of Libya? This action was made by Libya. Libya did that voluntarily by its own will, its own determination. The IAEA had nothing to do with that. It has no relations with it.
So are you saying that you deserve the Nobel Peace Prize?
I was not talking about myself. I was talking about Libya. And anyhow, I don't accept such a prize, and I don't even have respect for it.